welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, equity benchmarks snapped their three-day losing streak on Monday. And CJI Deepak Mishra has called the Indian judiciary as the most robust institution in the world. In America, the entry of Canada into a trade deal has been hailed, and President Donald Trump has said that India wanted to have a trade deal. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has slammed BJP State President Shwet Malik, and an internal rift among Congress leaders has come to fall. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... Key Indian equity indices settled in the green on Monday with the S&P BSE Sensex closing 299 points higher and the Nifty 50 reclaiming the 11,000 mark. This was after the government moved the NCLT to change the management of the beleaguered financial services company ILNFS. CJI Deepak Mishra has said that the Indian judiciary is the most robust institution in the world and young lawyers were assets having potential to develop their jurisprudence. Justice Gogoi, who will be sworn in as the CJI on Wednesday, said that Justice Mishra was a remarkable judge. A minister in Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan's cabinet was photographed at an event with 2611 Mumbai blast mastermind Hafiz Saeed in Islamabad. This comes a day after Pakistan assured the United Nations General Assembly that it was doing all it can to act against terrorism. An FIR has been filed against Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal for his recent tweet asking why Apple executive Vivek Tiwari was killed despite him being a Hindu. The FIR was registered by state BJP official spokesperson and lawyer Ashwini Upadhyay on grounds of promoting enmity on the grounds of caste and religion and defaming BJP leaders. The UIDAI has asked telecom companies to submit within the next 15 days a plan to stop using Aadhaar for customer authentication. The move comes days after the Supreme Court imposed curbs on the use of the 12-digit unique ID number. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has termed the Congress charges on the Rafale fighter jet deal as half-truth and baseless arguments. She said that their allegations will not tarnish the government's image. Sitharaman also denied that the Rafale deal had snagged jobs from the Indian aerospace major HAL. States have been asked to identify Rohingya refugees and collect their biometric details. The centre will send the biometric report collected by the states to the Myanmar government through a diplomatic channel. The Enforcement Directorate has attached assets worth 637 crore rupees of absconding jeweler Nirav Modi and his family. This includes two apartments in New York's iconic Central Park as part of its fresh action in the $2 million alleged bank fraud in the PNB. The Delhi High Court has allowed Gautam Navlakha, one of the five rights activists arrested in connection with Koregaon Bhima case, to be freed from house arrest. Navlakha's detention has exceeded 24 hours, which was untenable, the High Court said. Krishna Raj Kapoor, the wife of the late Raj Kapoor, has passed away following a cardiac arrest. She was 87. Amitabh Bachchan, Abhishek Bachchan, Alia Bhatt, Karan Johar, Ayan Mukherjee, Rani Mukherjee, Boni Kapoor, Aamir Khan, Arjun Kapoor and Anil Ambani, among others, attended her funeral. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are... President Donald Trump has praised Canada's entry into a reworked trade deal with the US and Mexico after the two countries forged a last-gasp agreement to salvage the NAFTA. Trump called the new USMCA agreement wonderful and a great deal for all three countries. President Donald Trump said that India wants to have a trade deal because it does not want the US to impose tariffs on their products. Trump's remarks comes days after Assistant Trade Representative Mark Linscott had detailed discussion with senior Indian officials in India. Indian origin Harvard Professor Geeta Gopinath has been appointed Chief Economist of the International Monetary Fund. IMF Managing Director Christine Lagarde congratulated the economist who has long championed the great inclusivity of women in global power circles. James Allison of the US and Tatsuko Honjo of Japan have jointly won the 2018 Nobel Prize in Medicine for developing a pioneering therapeutic approach for cancer treatment. The pair showed how the immune system can be effectively engaged in the fight against tumor cells. The Trump administration has sued the state of California in an effort to strike down its new net neutrality law, signed only hours earlier by Democratic Governor Jerry Brown. It prevents broadband providers from slowing down or blocking websites and charging higher fees for faster speeds. First Lady Melania Trump has left for a solo tour of Africa, months after President Donald Trump reportedly complained about the continent's shithole countries. The US First Lady is expected to visit Ghana, Malawi, Kenya and Egypt over 5 days, focusing on child welfare. Secretary of Defense James Mattis has pulled out of a planned visit to Beijing in October, marking the latest sign of deteriorating ties between the US and China. Mattis had planned to visit the Chinese capital to meet with senior Chinese officials to discuss security issues. The armed forces of the US and Philippines, along with Japan, opened the Kamindang 2 military exercises. These kicked off at Subic Bay that rests on the west coast of the Philippines' Luzon Island in the heavily contested South China Sea. Pakistan has revealed that it is seeking US assistance for peace along the border with India in a quid pro quo for Islamabad's support for Trump's campaign to stabilize Afghanistan. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi said this ahead of his UNGA speech. Actor Chris Evans has criticized rapper Kanye West call for the abolition of the 13th Amendment to the US Constitution, labeling the rapper's tweet maddening. West captioned it on a Twitter photo of himself wearing a pro-Donald Trump Make America Great Again hat. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has trashed state BJP President Shwet Malik's comment on the Congress government's functioning. Singh also accused Malik of resorting to cheap tactics to divert the attention of people from his own party's failure at the centre. Malik had earlier accused the state of misgovernance. An internal rift among Congress leaders of Lambi has come to fore, days before Chief Minister Amrinder Singh's rally in the area. Besides party workers' resentment with the senior leadership and state government also came before Chief Minister's political secretary, Captain Sandeep Sandhu. Senior Supreme Court lawyer Prashant Bhushan has suggested that the government should start levying 1% tax on 5 major capitalists of the country. He claimed that if the government starts doing this, around 2 crore physically challenged and elderly persons can be given a monthly pension of 3,000 rupees. Punjab has been ranked the top seller of power at the Indian Energy Exchange. The PSPCL sold power worth 426 crore rupees to other states last month. It achieved this milestone without imposing any power cuts. Gurpreet Singh of Ramuwala Kalan village has got a case registered against his NRI wife and her parents for cheating him of 25 lakh rupees. Singh's wife had abandoned her daughter back home and went to Canada. The couple had married in 2006. The Punjab Water Supply and Sewerage Board have shifted one of its divisions from Ludhiana to Abohar from October 1st. A decade ago, the then SAD BJP government had shifted PWSSB Abohar division to Firozpur, citing that no substantial work was to be carried out in Abohar. The canal department has identified 13 farmers who had been stealing water from Gang Canal, including twin districts of Sri Ganganagar and Hanumangarh. The department had carried out investigation after a breach in Gang Canal. The recovery of a huge amount of paddy rice mills in Firozpur, Zira and Jalalabad during raids has blown the lid off a multi-crore scam. Some rice millers are not shelling the entire stock of paddy procured by state agencies. The centre of attraction in Khamano village is the game of chess. The village is currently developing into a small township near Chandigarh-Ludhiana highway. For the last 16 years, the Khamano is the only village in Punjab to organise a cash prize tournament in chess. Punjabi singer Harman Sidhu has been arrested with 4 of his friends from a toll plaza in Sirsa by the Punjab police. A total of 52.10 grams of heroin was recovered from their possession. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources. From accounting firms to wedding planners in your city, all of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Krishna Kapoor, the widow of the legendary Bollywood actor-filmmaker Raj Kapoor, died at the age of 87 in Mumbai. On Monday, a family member said, Krishna, who married Raj Kapoor in May 1946, is survived by her sons Randhir Kapoor, Rishi Kapoor, Rajiv Kapoor and daughters Ritu Nanda and Reema Kapoor Jain. Regret to announce, I lost my mother early this morning. She died peacefully, Randhir said in a statement. Her granddaughter Ridhima Kapoor Sahni shared a throwback image on Instagram and wrote, I love you, I will always love you. R.I.P. Dadi. Ridhima's father, Rishi Kapoor, is not currently in the country as he left for the US just last week for a medical treatment. The film industry took to Twitter to express sorrow over her demise. Veteran actor Anupam Kher tweeted, "Deeply saddened to learn about the sad demise of Krishna Raj Kapoorji. She was one of the most dignified and affectionate ladies that I met. May her soul rest in peace. My condolences to the entire Kapoor and Nanda family. Om Shanti." Actress Sohali Khan wrote, "She was an incredible personality full of life and passion and with never a hair out place. She will be missed greatly. My deepest condolences to the family. Rest in peace, Krishna Raj Kapoor." Actress Tanushree Dutta had first raised sexual harassment allegation against veteran actor Nana Patekar in 2008. She brought the spotlight once again on her unpleasant experience of working with Nana during the shooting of Horn OK Please. Many celebrities have voiced their opinion on the same. One of them is Pooja Bhatt, whose strong outlook is a must watch.
"Magar main yahi kahungi ki kabhi bhi kisi ki shikayat agar hoti hai is cheezon ke bare mein, to you should not count it out. And I don't think that we should silence those voices. But I feel very strongly ki maine kabhi Bollywood ki support ki zarurat mangi nahi hai. Kabhi bhi. I am my own woman and agar koi aadmi ya koi shakhs mujhse agar badtameezi kare, main seedha court of law ke paas jaungi. Main na Bollywood ki support chahti hoon na mangti hoon. So I think to expect Bollywood stand there or not stand there is something that is I find it very frivolous conversation. Ki aapne support kiya, aapne nahi support kiya. So if you believe strongly in what you stand for, then go out there, kyunki sach ko PR ki zarurat nahi padti hai. Truth does not need PR. Truth like fire just burns. So if you believe in your truth, go out there and speak it strongly and do not expect anybody in the world to be holding your hand and supporting you. Bollywood is a great place and it's a wonderful place and you can expect people's support for award ceremonies, for weddings and for funerals. But for things and for matters where you have to go through the fire of life yourself, to phir apne khud ke balbute pe, apne khud ke pairon pe khade ho aur jaake duniya se lado."
Bhatt spoke at the red carpet of 9th Jagran Film Festival Award Night, where many other Bollywood filmmakers and actors too expressed their bitterness. Actress Kangana Ranaut, star of Mani Karnika, the Queen of Jhansi, captures the life story of Rani Lakshmibai, the teaser of which will release on the 2nd October. The filmmakers earlier dropped in a look of Kangana, where she donned a red sari with heavy jewellery. And thanks to Kangana Ranaut's team that we got to see two more looks of the warrior princess. Directed by Radha Krishna Jagarlamudi, it is slated to release on January 25th, 2019. Interestingly, actress Kangana Ranaut and Hrithik Roshan will clash again, this time at the box office. The two actors were involved in a row which began after Kangana hinted at Hrithik being her ex-boyfriend. What followed was an exchange of legal complaints and mudslinging. Now, their films are set to clash on the Republic Day 2019 weekend. Going back to Mani Karnika, the movie has been in the midst of a controversy ever since the news of Kangana stepping in behind the camera to direct Patchwork emerged. Actor Sonu Sood too has walked out of the film owing to his professional commitments towards Simba. Tanushree Dutta has brought to the spotlight and accused Nana Patekar of harassing her on the sets of 2008 film Horn OK Please 10 years ago. At the 9th Jagran Film Festival, when actor Varun Dhawan was asked what does he have to say about Tanushree's allegations on Nana Patekar, he said,
"Iski respect ek bahut hi important cheez hoti hai workplace mein, ek aurat ke liye, ek mard ke liye, ek bacche ke liye, aur hame apni industry safe karna hai. We have to make it safe for women, men and children, and हर इंसान को इक्वल रिस्पेक्ट दिया जाना चाहिए. एंड मतलब आई डोंट नो टू मच अबाउट दैट इशू, तो मैं बहुत खुल के नहीं कहना चाहूँगा उसके बारे में. कवर तो हो रहा है हर जगह, बट आई जस्ट स्पीक अबाउट द रिस्पेक्ट फैक्टर. अगर कोई इंसान इसके बारे में बोल रहा है खुल के, आई थिंक वी शुड हियर दैट पर्सन आउट. एंड इट टेक्स ग्रेट करेज टू टॉक लाइक दैट, सो आई अपलॉड दैट करेज.
स्वरा भास्कर सर,
इफ वर्किंग प्लेस हर इंसान, आदमी या औरत, उनका हक है. सेक्सुअल हैरेसमेंट एट द वर्कप्लेस हमारे समाज और हमारे देश का एक बहुत बड़ा मुद्दा है जिसे बहुत कम अटेंशन मिलता है और बहुत कम सीरियस बातचीत होती है इसके बारे में, और हम ज़्यादातर करके एक्चुअली अनअवेयर रहते हैं इसके बारे में. मुझे लगता है इस मुद्दे पे बहुत सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन पॉसिटिव है. सो आई थिंक दैट अच्छी चीज़ है कि ये बातें बाहर आ रही हैं और हमें बहुत एक रिस्पॉन्सिबल तरीके से इसके बारे में बात करनी चाहिए और एक करेक्टिव रूप से अपने अपने वर्कप्लेस को सेफ बनाना चाहिए.
हिना खान सेड
ऐसा होता है तो बहुत गलत है बाकी आई हैव नो आइडिया अबाउट इट आई वुड डेफिनेटली लाइक टू रीड अबाउट इट शायद मैंने मिस कर दिया हो देन ओनली आई कैन गिव अ टेक ऑन इट बट अगर ऐसा हुआ है तो बहुत ही ज़्यादा गलत है आई थिंक वर्क प्लेस एक ऐसी जगह होती है काम को आप पूछते हैं और जहाँ पर जिस चीज़ को आप पूछते हैं जहाँ पर आप काम करते हैं वहाँ पर डेफिनेटली एक ऐसा डेकोरम होना चाहिए कि हर कोई कंफर्टेबल फील करे तो वो तो एक बहुत ही बेसिक चीज़ है आई कंप्लीटली बिलीव इन इट
Actor Akshay Kumar featured in Padman that depicted issues of menstrual hygiene and post that he continued to raise awareness about the importance of the same and tackling the taboos associated with menstruation. Now, Badshaho actress Isha Gupta follows similar footsteps as she was seen endorsing biodegradable pads and green menstrual hygiene. At the launch, she said,
Sanities, first of all, is biodegradable, which really excited me, sir, honestly. The fact that someone has put, you know, we are banning plastic. Let's just start by that. We are banning plastic, but we haven't thought about something like this before. And this is where I stepped in and this is what I said. Yes, we need to now start a revolution and start something better. And that's when Sanities came in. It's biodegradable, it's fresher, it's healthier. It is much, much cheaper when it comes to costing than any other sanitary, commercially sold sanitary napkin in this day and age.
Isha also expressed her opinion on the ongoing controversy of Tanushree Dutta and Nana Patekar. On film front, Gupta will be seen in Total Dhamal, sharing screen space with an ensemble cast.